Welcome to this week's Monday Minutes. My name is Kelly.
And my name is Jesse. And this week we are going to show you how to batch modify items in your collection. Now, if you remember a couple of weeks ago, we showed you how to batch delete items. This time we're going to show you how to batch modify.
Yeah, this is going to be great. And you know what? The process is a lot the same, but it's good to go through it step by step. That's how I learn best to go through the process. Now we are going to start again in our favorite place, item search. We really need to make some t-shirts, Jesse. Like, what are we thinking? Why don't we have an item t-shirt? The great opportunity with item search, and we've probably, you know, talked about this 100 times, is just the ability to get information really easily. It's like it's an SQL report running in the background, but you don't even have to worry about something like that. You could just know that you are running some sort of report to get details of your records. I always call it my project search. In this case, we can always say we were moving shelving location or updating a collection code or changing a different status. You have lots of opportunities in the batch item modification tool that will allow you to change data that you can find. So I'm going to run this batch item modification and just look at everything in my fiction collection just for fun. Now, maybe we decided to move everything, get rid of the collection code or whatever the reason we may do. Is that the purpose is to make some change in a bulk of these items. We're presented with a nice list. We can choose all of these. The great part about the item search results, you can look at those results once you run that search, as well as at any point, send that to a CSV or a barcode file. So you could say, yep, this is everything, or I just want to click maybe everything I'm looking at, the first 20 rows, and send those to a barcode file. But one of the easy ways to get items into your item modification tool is through a barcode file. And there's a couple ways, and we'll talk about those. So I'm going to send this over to a barcode file. And then this is where it gets very exciting because we have a new staff interface, right, Jesse?
Yeah.
This has caught me a few times. Has it caught you? Where to go?
Yes.
We are going to head over to cataloging now. Back in the day, we went to tools. Now in the cataloging is where all the kind of batch procedures move with cataloging, and which to me makes a lot of sense. Just old habits. Within the center column, we have a batch item modification. This screen is similar to batch item deletion, which we showed a couple weeks ago. It also is similar to your batch record modification and batch record deletion. And I love the consistency. I'm going to use my barcode file which I just generated, but I can also scan barcodes into this text box. If I had a cart of things that I needed to change, I can certainly do that instead. Grab that barcode file, hit that continue. And then I'm presented with all the details that I just added to that barcode file. Now, if you were really focusing on the details, all the columns that you see are showing on this screen. And you can, of course, change or remove some of these to make it easier to look at. Again, this is up to you how much detail you want to get into what you're looking at here. At this point, the real key is what fields do I want to batch change for these items specifically? If I was changing that collection code from fiction to something else in this area, I could go ahead and do that. I could change the shelving location. Some of these with little boxes, I could clear that status. So maybe you were batch modifying damaged and you wanted to remove that damage status. You could go ahead and click that and that will remove that damage status. So you have lots of variables here. And I know that we've done a Monday Minutes on the regex. So we'll link that as well, just to kind of know what that regex is on the side. I'm going to go ahead and go crazy and just change the collection code to biography just for fun. you know, the inner cataloger probably is like screaming at me, but again, it's just for testing purposes. And now we have, since 2211, we have this new blue box that tells us that this is enqueued, it's ready to go. And I can go ahead and click that detail if I wanted to.
Which, I mean, look at this. This is fantastic because it actually never showed you this before. Like, you actually have all the details of what you just modified right in front of you, which I'd probably print my screen. I'm that kind of person. The other way that we could bring items into an batch item modification process is through the reports. Jesse, you want to talk about that?
Yeah. So what this allows us to do is go into our reports module, and let's say you're looking for something. In this case, we're going to show you collection codes that are missing, and we want to go update all of those titles to show that particular collection code. Just like we saw with that report we ran when we did the deletion Monday minutes, you'll see we also have this, which gives us the batch item modification. So now I can just quickly click that and it will take me directly into that same screen.
I mean, it's fantastic. So there's multiple ways that you can do your batch operations depending on the scenario. That's what I love. You have different scenarios for each thing. And that's a great kind of feature with Koha, right?
Yep. Awesome.
Okay. Well, that wraps it up. And thanks so much for watching, and have a great week.
Have a great week.
Bye.
Bye.